Most people in life are familiar with our process of the American president. It usually means that a bunch of candidates have thrown their hats in the pool, and at some point the money that they earn, and at some point the people that they churn, eventually propel them to a position of running for the president. We allow this in each of the parties, and we usually talk mainly only about two candidates, but that's not really fair. We really should be talking more about independents today because many of them have marvelous ideas. But we also know that a president needs to be of a certain age and a certain degree and a certain seasoning in the work of government. It's the whole freaking reason that we have this current president, and that is absolutely true. That President Joe Biden is the best man for the job is absolutely true. Take a look at the people that were running for candidacy, and it's not that they didn't have great ideas. It's not that they didn't have marvelous concepts. It's they just didn't have enough experience in all forms of government. They also didn't really have a lot of interest or innovation per se, outside of maybe Marion, within the concept of small business. You see, small business today are the things that keep America running. Small businesses are what we love to go into when we're visiting a town or traveling or touring a certain place in America. It's national records restaurants that of course we love to eat at because we can always expect they'll meet a certain quality of standard, and that is typically true. But what we have to do is keep encouraging small business owners to keep building and growing for their families and our communities, and that's what marketing people do. In life, we have moments of time to speak the truth about certain industries. Certain industries are way oversaturated, like construction in terms of homes, and buildings in terms of what's already available we don't need any more built. We don't need any more land being depleted and more trees being ruined. We need those trees for oxygen, and we need those trees for the birds and the bees that help to, well, create our food. In life, we have to tell the beekeepers when we've got a bee's nest that is out of place, like hanging on a building that's abandoned. We've got to be able to call that local beekeeper, that local honey maker, and say, hey, I've got some bees for you. Do you think they might work for you? And I don't know enough about bees to know if they're the right kind of bees to make a little honey with some other bees. But you know what they might do? They might make a marvelous new brew. So that's what I'm wondering about how to do. And here's the problem. Small beekeeping businesses don't always have websites. And then if you do have a website, you're like, where's your friggin' phone number so I can call you and say, come get these bees. Save their lives before I kill them with something. Now, in life, we have moments of time to talk about the other critters that drive us crazy, that slide underneath the doors of businesses and literally ruin our food, ruin our pet food, and openly do not keep the field mice out, because I've seen them now running up and down the walls, which I didn't know they could do that like Spider-Man, but they can, apparently. And somehow, they got suction cups on their feet, I guess. Did not know that, but at this point, I don't mind them, because they're sort of funny, and they remind me of certain skill sets, not at all, but certain ideas that come out of the metaphysical realm that how every animal of the world has a sort of spiritual meaning and an implication for your life. But that's another story for another day, as a pagan who wants to build the Illinois Pagan Federation.